quite proud of myself for that find.
The Jarls are upset.
More chatter.
They don't all support you.
Damn the Jarls.
They demand the moot.
And damn the moot! We should risk letting those milk drinkers put Torek's woman on the throne? She'll hand Skyrim over to the elves on a silver plate.
All the more reason, then. The crown would legitimize your claim.
A crown doesn't make a king.
No, but this one.
If it even exists.
It exists, and it will be the symbol of the righteousness of our cause. Think about it. The jagged crown. It heralds back to a time before Jarls and Moots. Back to the time when the king was a king because his enemies fell before him, and his people rose because they loved him. Skyrim needs that king. You will be that king, Ulfric. You must be.
You're certain you found it?
When have I ever been false with you?
Fine. I'll send the Unblooded here with you. Fancy a crawl through a moldering dungeon to see if you can't stir up Galmar's jagged crown.
It will be there. You'll see. You're alive.
The Unblooded.
Rick, a drink.
Is that me?
I have to admit, I didn't think we'd be seeing you again. I misjudged you. You're definitely Stormcloak material. It's time we made this official. You ready to take the oath?
What?
Oh. Before you're one of us, you must swear fealty to Jarl Ulfric Stormcloak, future High King of Skyrim. You must also pledge unswerving loyalty to your fellow Stormcloaks, to Skyrim, and to her people.
And it's really not enough that I just want to fight the Imperials and get them out of your land.
You can stick a sword through an Imperial any day you want, but that doesn't make you a Stormcloak. We're not just fighting Imperials. We're fighting to restore Skyrim to her glory and give her the king she deserves.
Hmm. Well, I think that I'm ready to take this oath. I do owe the Nord people quite a bit. Without them, I would still be stuck in Morrowind. So yes, I'm ready to take your
That's
oath.
That's the spirit. By swearing this oath, you become one of us. A hero of the people. A true son of Skyrim. A Stormcloak. Repeat after me. I do swear my blood and honor to the service of Ulfric Stormcloak.
I do swear on my blood and honor to the service of Ulfric Stormcloak.
Jarl Vindhelm and true High King of Skyrim.
Jarl of Windhelm and the true High King of Skyrim.
As Talos is my witness, may this oath bind me to death and beyond.
With Talos as my witness, may this oath bind me to death and beyond.
Even to my lord, as to my fellow brothers and sisters in arms.
Even to my lord, as to my fellow brothers and sisters in arms.
All hail the Stormcloaks, the true sons and daughters of Skyrim.
All hail the Stormcloaks, the true sons and daughters of Skyrim.
Now you're one of us, which means you get to tag along on a little trip with me. Oh, and here. You're a Stormcloak now. You ought to look the part.
Aye, thank you. So I guess Bran'dar is a son of Skyrim, yes? Can you tell me what is the aim of this war? I'm not sure I completely understand what
First,
you're going for
we'll
here.
We'll kick the Thalmor and their bloody Imperial puppets out of the country. Then we will rebuild Skyrim into the land she once was. When we are done with that, we will take our army to the Dominion and show those pointy-eared bastards. Not every man is fit to be their slave.
kicking elf butt. I do like the sound of that. So, what is this mission you spoke of? Something about the Jagged Crown?
I have found the final resting place of the Jagged Crown. Can you believe it? Well, I'm almost certain. We're headed to Korvanjund, but if old King Borgus is indeed buried there, we're bound to run into trouble of some kind. Your fellow Stormcloaks are already assembling outside the tomb. I'll meet you there as soon as I'm finished up here.
Sounds good. Could you tell me what the Jagged Crown is supposed to be?
Have you not heard that ancient verse? Maw unleashing rays of snow, of dragons from the blue brought down, birth the walking winter's woe, the High King in his Jagged Crown. Going way back to King Harald's time, or even before, the High King always wore the Jagged Crown. It was the symbol of his might and power. The crown is made from the bones and teeth of ancient dragons, and it is said to contain a portion of the power of every king who has worn it. True or not, who would dare deny Ulfric's claim when the legendary Jagged Crown sits upon his brow?
Fascinating. Do you know for a fact that the crown is at Korvanjund?
It's true. The location of the crown was lost with King Borgus after the Great Hunt killed him while he was off on his damned Alessian campaigns. But legend holds, his body was secretly returned to Skyrim and buried with the crown, its exact whereabouts lost in the following wars of succession. Through sources that shall remain nameless, I've tracked down what I believe to be the final resting place of King Borgus, Korvanjund. If the crown exists, it will be there.
Korvanjund. So you have your ear to the ground as well, Mr. Galmar Stonefist. I think you and Bran'dar are not so different after all. And is this the reason that you anticipate some danger there?
The Great Hunt killed old King Borgus. Gods only know with what profane arts those elves cursed his remains. Curses notwithstanding, the tombs of kings are always full of traps to ward off grave robbers, are they not? But nothing a band of Stormcloaks can't handle, I assure you.
You realize you've just said that we are grave robbers. Well, I suppose Bran'dar has done worse things in his life. Okay, I shall see you at Korvanjund.
Don't wait around for me.
Indeed I shan't.
Get your
Imperials seem to have taken much of this land.
Welcome to the fight, brother.
Yes, indeed. Soon this entire map shall be blue, yes? Bran'dar will help with that. Markarth, Karthwist, and so many places I've not been thusly. Skyrim is a large land. Bran'dar plans to, plunder it. At least to his liking. I shall make myself a life here. I think it's not so bad, better than being ruled over by Imperials in Cyrodiil. So we shall push the Imperials out, Bran'dar will find a warm place in Skyrim, and perhaps we will be able to settle, eventually. At least that is the hope. Korvanjund. Well, I hope that Richard knows the way. I have not even gotten any directions from this Galmar Stonefist about where to start looking. But I suppose if I find a group of Stormcloak soldiers, that would be a good place to start, huh? Yeah, and what are you doing, Mr. Pointy Ears? Just looking mean, I see. Well, have it your way. Fascinating. The Dunmer hold up in Windhelm. I suppose Ulfric is not such a bad man after all. The Nords and the Dunmer have always sort of been hand in hand. The Dunmer dislike the High Elves as much as anyone. Come, Richard. We're going to Korvanjund. We must find the Jagged Crown for Mr. Galmar's Stone Feast. He said that he will meet me there, so perhaps you can... Oh, I am so sorry. Perhaps you can smell him out. He's a Nord in a bear outfit. So if you smell a Nord and a bear, just let me know. You can pull against the reins, and we will go that way. Kinsgrove. Yes, I heard talk of this in the inn as well. Rayloff, is that you, friend?
I'd consider joining up myself.
The Unguard. Stormcloak and the Unguard. My, you're ambitious. Ah, and the rain has finally stopped. When did this happen? Let's see. Should get rid of this armor, I do think. Where's my Stormcloak Curious? Yes. Not quite as strong. But it will make me look a bit more official, I do think. Yes, quite nice. And my helm. Which helm was I wearing, I think this one. Yes. Looking lovely, Mr. Bran'dar. Thank you so much, Mr. Bran'dar. Korvanjund. I don't suppose there is a sign for that. Shorestone and Riften. Mr. Galmar should have been a bit more specific with his directions, no? Ah well, like anyone else around here, they just kind of say, here's a town, go find it. Alright, we shall do just that then. I've got plenty of things in my bag as well that I should probably offload before we go too crazy. Diving into a king's grave. I suppose there would be much more things in the king's grave to fill up my bag, Spider's eggs. Perhaps we could find some alchemical ingredients to help us on the journey, My. This mammoth met quite an end. Well, let us see what ended it. My bet is spiders, but you can never be too sure. And if there is a nest of spiders here, we should be rid of it. Yes, indeed. I hear them skittering about already. Disgusting creatures. But I have just the remedy. A bit of shock. Shock and awe. Hello there. Goodbye. wonderful. Is there another one? I do hear them. Yes. Quite far in the distance. I shall go for this one that is a bit closer, no? Here. Well done. Pick them off instead of jumping into the spider pit. There are many of them down there. How could I miss so large a group? Oh my. Here they come. Do they spot me? I'm unsure how spiders sense things. Perhaps it is vibrations in the ground. Which is why Bran'dar tried not to move too much. But I guess he moved a bit too much, and that one caught him, as did that. By my count, there should be one more out there somewhere. Hello. Quite a foul place. Yes, I need my arrows back. I have very few of these left. What have they caught here? A skeever? Poor little creature. would have made some good potions before the juice was sucked out of him, hmm? Ah well, I'm sure we shall find some more. I'm sure spiders are not all that inhabits this cave. Hmm, as is usually the case. It is light on the top, heavy on the bottom. Perhaps there's a spider queen. And if we get rid of her, then we need to worry anymore about becoming infested. Ah! Disgusting. Just clear these out of the way a bit. I do think that they sense me wiggling their webs, as it were. There's one down. Yes. Unsure where to look for Bran'dar, are you? Piece of cake. One by one, they fall. It's so wonderful. Mm-hmm. Another? Yes, just keep marching. There you are. Piece of cake. Ah, Bran'dar does not want to go down there quite yet. Quite a fall it would be, yes? I need the arrows. I'm going to run out eventually. That will be quite sad. These arrows are quite nice. I suppose I could reshape the iron ones, but that orcish steel is just so good. It's not quite the same as making the iron arrows more jagged. There's more to it than that. There's one, there's two. I think we are clear. Clear for landing. My goodness. How deep could this possibly go? And a miss. Swing and a miss. But we don't miss twice. Ah, I have much venom. It is not very good for brewing, but it has its uses. That spider seems to have fallen in the pool. We'll escape Bran'dar for now. Ah, these webs. Not very nice at all. Endless skittering. Always. I'm sure I shall hear this in my ears for days. Come along. Anybody out there? Not bad. Make sure to get my arrows back, at least the ones that haven't been destroyed. I don't have much time to craft the shaft once more. I think these orcish arrows should have a bit more work done on the shaft, you see. It seems to break a little bit too easy. I only am able to recover about half of the arrows that I spend. Yes, very nice shot. Right in the thorax. It is a scientific term. Bran'dar read it in a book. As he reads so many things. Oh my. That is a big one. Hops down from the ceiling. I guess the chest would not be so easy to get, huh? I'm still not seen. Simply a giant insect. He's not so smart, huh? A couple more of those. We should be done. Ah! A lovely shot. Wow, what a big boy. Came from up there in the ceiling, I see. Might I have some arrows back? Thank you so much. Yes. And let us see what it holds in the chest. My goodness. Vampire armor. That's quite spiffy. Yes. Amethyst, lockpicks, soul gems, septums. Ooh, silver rings. I do enjoy. And this dwarven sword seems to be better than the orcish one. I suppose I should take. We will drop off our orcish sword here. Store it for just a little while. I do have so much on me. Let's get rid of this hide helmet, hide shield. I don't see myself using this anytime soon. Stormcloak curious? I shall see you later. It was a very nice gesture, but how can you beat this? Vampire armor. Minor destruction versus destruction. I do like the darker color of the minor destruction, but a bit less, a bit less magic cost is always helpful. Yes, looking pretty good, I do think. Does this lair go even further? Are there more giant spiders to battle? I fear to say that it does. And I fear to say that there probably are. The cobwebs are just endless. This seems to be going back up. Maybe we will be okay. Perhaps I have finished this place, yes? It seems so. Wonderful. A little exploration never hurt anyone. And I might have saved some farmers from this rain every time. And it seems we barely missed it. Most fortunate. We might have saved some farmers' cows from being eaten by the giant spiders. This is some work that I can feel good about, yes? Now, where would that jagged crown be? I haven't seen a large group of Stormcloak soldiers. Not quite yet. Oh my. Some giants just there. And they do hide a chest. Bran'dar wants to have a look. Just a little peek. I promise not to take so much from your chest. I don't have room for it anyways. Just a look couldn't hurt, could it? Oh my. He does have eyes on me, does he not? Everything is okay, friend. I'm just going to come around this way. Yes. Leather helmet. That's quite nice. They have quite a bit of goods in here as well. Perhaps the giants know something of alchemy. Void salts. My goodness. Bow of arcing. Heavy armor. Bracers of alchemy. My goodness. I could use many of these things. Yes. Let us wear this charmed necklace so I can carry these things. And the giant's too dumb to know the difference. They shall find it out soon enough, I do suppose. Very well done, Bran'dar. Yes. Let us get rid of some fur boots and gauntlets. I don't have space in my bag for these things. And they are far too simple. Where's that helmet that I did find? I should like to try it on. Helmet of Destruction. Yes, now our destruction spell should be able to cast for an exceedingly long time. Yes. Very good idea. Quite proud of myself for that find. Who else would brave a giant's camp, Very few, I would wager. I don't think this is what I'm looking for. No storm cloaks outside. But a bit of alchemical ingredients wouldn't hurt, And bugs. I will brew you up. Make you a bit more useful than just providing some nightlight, huh? This seems to be a rather magical place as well. Much overgrowth. I can only hope that I will not see those bee creatures inside. You remember the ones. They swarm around so disgustingly. Let us see what we can find here, huh?
1, 2, 3, 4. Goodbye, goodbye, see you again. Goodbye, goodbye, see you, my friends.